Hallo Leute! Welcome back to a new video! Willkommen zurück zu einem neuen Video. This is Lesson 10 of the Free German Course for Beginners. My name is Steffi and after this lesson you will know how to use to be and to have in German. Like always, you will find the PDF for today's lesson in the description below the video. You can download it completely for free. And you will find there the whole summary of today's lesson. Subscribe to my channel if you like the way I teach, if you want to learn German with me. And now let's start with the verb to be. Sein. I already used sein in past lessons, but let's have a closer look at it today. Sein is a irregular verb. This means there is no rule on how to conjugate it. You will have to memorize it. But don't worry, that's what we are doing today. Let's start! In lesson 8, you have learned the personal pronouns in German. They are ich, du, sie, es, wir, ihr, and sie, or sie, if you mean you formal. But let's add the verb sein. How do we use it? Ich bin, bin. Du bist, bist. Sie, es, ist. Ist. For all three, we have to use ist. Wir sind. Sind. Ihr seid. Seid. And sie sind. So as you can see, wir and sie have the same. That's why you always have to use the personal pronouns. You cannot just skip them. And here are some example sentences. Ich bin verlobt. Ich bin verlobt. I am engaged, by the way. Du bist verheiratet. Du bist verheiratet. You are married. Ist geschieden. Ist geschieden. He is divorced. Sie ist beim Arzt. Sie ist beim Arzt. She is at the doctor's. Es ist Herbst. Es ist Herbst. It's autumn. Wir sind befreundet. Wir sind befreundet. We are friends. Ihr seid glücklich. Ihr seid glücklich. You are happy, I hope. And here we have to pay attention that we spell seid correctly. Because maybe you have noticed, but seid sounds like it's spelled with a T at the end. But it is a D. Let's have a look at this two examples here. Ich warte schon seit 3 Stunden. Ihr seid schon wieder zu spät. Ich warte schon seit 3 Stunden. Ihr seid schon wieder zu spät. So these two seits have different meanings. The first one is the preposition seit. It means since or for. The second one is our verb sein to be conjugated. Ihr seid. So they sound exactly the same and we learned it in lesson 8. Sie can mean they in English or you formal. So the sentence Sie sind auf Arbeit can mean they are at work. It can also mean you are at work depending on who you're talking to. Sie is the first word of the sentence here, so it must be capitalized, even if it means they. Well done, guys! So far, so good. This is how you conjugate to be, sein in German. Let's move forward. Let's go to the next verb, which is to have. Haben in German. In singular, it is ich habe. Du hast. Sie es hat. Wir haben. Ihr habt. Sie haben. Wir and sie have the same verb conjugation, haben. Wir haben, sie haben. Let's look at some example sentences. Ich habe eine Frage. Ich habe eine Frage. I have a question. Du hast das Gepäck. Du hast das Gepäck. You have the luggage. Hat heute Geburtstag. Hat heute Geburtstag. Today it's his birthday. Sie hat Fieber. Sie hat Fieber. She has fever. Es hat gestern geregnet. Es hat gestern geregnet. It rained yesterday. Wir haben Hunger. Wir haben Hunger. We are hungry. Give us food. Ihr habt ein Auto. Ihr habt ein Auto. You have a car. You, plural, have a car. Sie haben ein Haus. Sie haben ein Haus. They have a house. Or you have a house. You, formal. These two verbs are really important and super useful. It's very important that you know them because we use them a lot. Especially if you just started to learn German. At the beginning, you learn a lot on how to express yourself and how to talk in the first point of view. So it's always I am, I have, and so on. So it's very important that you memorize them and that you know how to conjugate them. You already encountered to be in the second lesson of this free German course. It was introduction. I said, hallo, ich bin Steffi. Hi, I am Steffi. So as you see, the first moment when you meet a new person, you will already use the verb sein. It's really useful to know it. And it wouldn't be a Lerne-Deutsch lesson if there wouldn't be a homework, of course. Hausaufgabe. Let's do it. I prepared 4 sentences for you. And the verb is missing. Oopsie. You need to choose the correct verb form. Let's do it. Write your answers in the comments, so I will see your answers. So to find the right answer, you should follow the 3 steps. First, have a look at the table. Second, which pronoun is used in the sentence? And number 3, choose the right verb form. Let's do it. Sentence number 1 is wir im Urlaub. Wir im Urlaub. We are on vacation. So we need the verb sein here, but of course we have to conjugate it. So what is the right form? Sentence number 2 is mein Ehemann. Mein Ehemann. He is my husband. One day. Sentence number 3 is sie keine Arbeit. Sie keine Arbeit. She doesn't have a job. So now we need the verb haben. But how do we conjugate it? And remember, sie has 2 options. Depending on the context, it could mean she, it could mean they, it could mean you formal. And I will let them all pass, don't you worry. And the last sentence for today is sentence number 4. Wir, drei Kinder. Wir, drei Kinder. We have 3 children. What is missing? Write your answers in the comments. I'm curious to see your answers. I hope you enjoyed today's video, because das war's für heute. This was it for today. Congratulations, guys! You made it through another lesson. Every lesson you're getting closer to your goal, speaking in German. And I'm really glad that you chose to join this free German course for beginners and that I can teach you German. So thank you for that. So I hope you enjoyed today's lesson. Don't forget to download the PDF for free. You will find there all the notes from today. And I wish you a wonderful day. See ya in the next lesson. Macht's gut, Leute. Tschüss.